After the war, the Pandavas returned to Hastinapur. They went to meet Dhritarashtra and Gandhari, whose world had collapsed with the death of all their sons. Dhritarashtra and Gandhari were inconsolable. Gandhari accused Krishna, "Madhusudan, if you had really wished, you could have stopped this war and the destruction of the Kuru dynasty. I curse you that like me, you too shall be forced to witness the destruction of the Yadav race." "I accept your curse," said Sri Krishna calmly. Yudhishthira was then duly crowned as the emperor of the Kurus to the accompaniment of Vedic mantras. Bhim held the reins of his chariot. Arjun held a royal umbrella over Yudhishthira. Nakul and Sahadev stood fanning him. Arjun had befriended Bhishma, the grandsire, on the 10th day of the Kurukshetra war. He was now lying on his bed of arrows, waiting for the appropriate time to depart. The Pandavas, Dhritarashtra and Sri Krishna went to Kurukshetra to see Bhishma. There were still 56 days left for the Uttarayan to begin. Bhishma imparted the knowledge of statecraft, kingly duties, the duties of a Kshatriya, politics and administration to Yudhishthira. This discourse lasted for all of 56 days. On the final day, Bhishma fixed his mind and senses on Lord Krishna, who blessed him and said, "You have not done anything wrong, never spoke a lie, nor acted against Dharma in your life. You have never shirked your duty and have upheld your vow in every respect. You are now free to join the celestial world of the Vasus." Using the power of yoga, Bhishma concentrated his entire energy in his head and left earthly body through the root of the Brahma Chakra. A shining halo left his body and travelled heavenwards. Once, Maharshi Vedvyas came to see Yudhishthira. He advised him to dispel your mind's grief at having to fight an undesired war, and also to quell the anarchy arising from the destruction of most kings in the Kurukshetra war, you must perform the Ashwamedha Yajna. Soon, Abhimanyu's wife Uttara delivered. But because of the effect of Ashwathama's Brahmastra, her baby boy was delivered lifeless. Sri Krishna immediately entered Uttara's chamber and consoled her and all the ladies. He said, "If I have never spoken a lie in my life, never run away from battle, have slain evil doers, and if dharma and power be present in me, then let this child rendered lifeless by the Brahmastra come to life." So saying, Sri Krishna placed the toe of his right foot upon the chest of the infant. The next moment the baby boy came to life and started crying loudly. There was a joy in the Pandava family. Sri Krishna named the boy Parikshit. Yudhishthira's Ashwamedha Yajna began on an auspicious day. Arjun escorted the sacred horse and forced all rulers to accept Yudhishthira as their emperor. Arjun returned victorious. Yudhishthira's Ashwamedha Yajna was a grand success.